So in the section on partial derivatives, so far we've been learning lots about first partial derivatives. So the natural question that you should be thinking about is, well, okay, what happens for like second partial derivatives, third partial derivatives, so on and so forth here. So let's have a discussion about higher order derivatives. And so one notation here, you know, maybe the easiest notation is just something like f sub xx. So, you know, f sub x would be our partial derivative with respect to x. F sub xx is the idea here is that you take the partial derivative with respect to x of partial derivative f with respect to x. Or So first you take the partial derivative f with respect to x, and then you do another partial derivative with respect to x. And so we can write this as partial squared f over partial x squared. F sub xy. So the order of subscripts here tells you in what order to take the partial derivative. So this says, first take a partial derivative with respect to x, and then take the partial derivative of that answer with respect to y. And so we can write this partial squared f over partial y partial x. So this one would be first take the partial derivative of f with respect to y, and then do partial derivative of that with respect to x, partial squared f over partial x partial y. And then, f sub y, two partial derivatives with respect to y. Okay, so, this is how we do second derivatives. Later in this video, I'll be talking about third and fourth and whatever, higher order derivatives. Let's maybe crunch out an example here. So f of xy is equal to x squared sine y plus e to the xy plus y to the fourth. So let's start just by calculating out the first partial derivatives. So the x partial derivative would be 2x sine y plus y looks like a constant here. So this would be y e to the xy, and then y is a constant with respect to x, so that's the partial derivative of this with respect to x is 0. Our y partial derivative here, derivative of sine y is cosine y. Of course, the x squared looks like a constant from the lens of y. X is a constant again, plus x e to the xy plus y, the derivative, the partial derivative of this respect to y is 4y cubed. Okay, so this is the setup. So now let's go and calculate stuff we actually care about. So this is take two derivatives with respect to x. So when we take a derivative of this with respect to x, we would get 2 sine y plus another factor of y comes down, y squared e to the xy. Next up would be fxy. So this says take the derivative with respect to x first and then take the derivative with respect to y. So taking the derivative with respect to y here gives us 2x times cosine y. And then we'll have to use the product rule. We'll have to use the product rule here. So it's y times the derivative of this with respect to y. And that would be x e to the xy plus e to the xy times the partial derivative of y with respect to y. And that's just 1. Okay. Next up is f sub yx here. And so take the derivative with respect to y first, And then take the derivative with respect to x. Okay, so we're taking the derivative with respect to x of this right here. So this would give us 2x cosine y plus, okay, we have to use the product rule here. It's going to be x times the derivative of this with respect to x, xy e to the xy, plus e to the xy times the partial derivative x with respect to x is just e to the xy. And then finally, f sub yy, we take the partial derivative of this with respect to y. And that would give us negative x squared sine y, plus x squared e to the xy plus 12y squared. Okay, so take a moment here and just look and see if you can, you can think about this and also see if you spot anything interesting. So the thing that you may have spotted here, take a look at these two answers here. F sub xy is 2x cosine y plus xy e to the xy plus e to the xy. F sub yx is also 2xy cosine y plus xy e to the xy plus e to the xy. And whenever we see something like that, we should be wondering, is it an accident or not? And this is not an accident. So we have the mixed derivative theorem. That's what your book calls it. I also put Clairaut's theorem. The book also, notes says call Clairaut's theorem. Clairaut's theorem is what I was taught, so I will often call it Clairaut's theorem. What it says is that if f of x, y, and its partial derivatives, f sub x, f sub y, f sub x, y, f sub y, x, are defined throughout open region containing a, b, where they're all continuous. This just says they're all nice enough here. If everything going on is nice, then f sub x, y will equal f sub y, x at that point. And more generally speaking, if f sub x, y, all of the partial derivatives are continuous everywhere you care about, then these two are just going to always equal each other. So everything is nice, and most of the time they will be nice. These will equal each other, and so that will be certain simplifications that we'll be able to make later on. So planning ahead, section 14.7. There's something where in section 14.7 where you would want to calculate all four of these second order partial derivatives, but you only have to calculate three of them because these two are equal to each other. So that is nice. Let's do just a quick example here, a quick application of this. So find partial squared w, partial x, partial y. If w is equal to xy plus e to the y over y squared plus 1. So the order of the partial derivatives here, this would be w sub yx. So the problem is trying to tell us to take a y derivative first before we take an x derivative. But, if we say, e to the y over y squared plus 1, that would be a little bit of work. That would be a little bit of work for us to compute that derivative. We have to use the quotient rule a little bit. But this is all going to, everything here is going to be nice. We're not going to, y squared plus 1, we're not going to be divided by 0 or anything like that. We're going to satisfy all of the conditions here of this mixed derivative theorem. And so by Clairaut's theorem, this is w sub xy. So instead of taking a y derivative first, we can just take the x derivative first. And look how much easier that's going to make our life, because the x partial derivative of xy will be y, and the x partial derivative of all of this will just be 0. So w sub xy is going to equal just 1. You could also get there, you know, it's a decent exercise if you want to try it. Take the y partial derivative first, and then the x partial derivative. See that you get one, but I think we can agree that this is probably the easiest way to do things. Okay, so that is a lot about second order partial derivatives. We'll be using those, as I said, in future sections. Something that doesn't quite come up as frequently, but it's worth just commenting on, is higher order past second order derivatives. So if I were to throw something at you that's like f sub x, y, x, x, y. So this would be take x partial derivative first, then y, then x, then x, then y. So this would be a fifth order partial derivative, x, y, x, x, y, so on and so forth. You also have a version of this for, like, you also have a version of Clairaut's theorem, you know, also can be generalized to third, fourth, etc. derivatives. So assuming everything is nice, and, you know, we have to, nice is going to be some kind of continuity condition, you can say things like f sub x x y y, two x derivatives followed by two y derivatives, it's going to be equal f x y x y, you know, an x derivative of a y derivative, x derivative of a y derivative is going to equal f sub x y y x, and there's a bunch more ways to do that. As long as you're taking two x derivatives and two y derivatives, If everything here is nice, it doesn't matter which order you take those derivatives. But to finish off this video, let's do this example here. Find f sub yx, yz, where f of x, yz is 1 minus 2x, y squared z plus x squared y. Let's just go ahead and do it in this order. Y derivative first. Yeah, I guess the other thing here, now we're dealing with three variables, x, y, and z. That shouldn't be scary to us. Okay, so the y partial derivative will be 0 minus, that 2 comes down as a 4xyz plus x squared. F sub yx, now we're going to take a partial derivative with respect to x here. So minus 4yz plus 2x. F sub yxy, take the partial derivative of this with respect to y, negative 4z, that's a constant with respect to y. So minus 4z plus 0. F sub xyxz, derivative of that respect to z is negative 4. Okay, so this should be a pretty straightforward, you know, if you can compute out first partial derivatives, you should be able to, without much difficulty, be able to compute out second, third, and higher order partial derivatives. And then, I guess the other big thing is just knowing this Clairaut's theorem right here.